educators on each of those respective teams are each team is comprised of four blocking skaters, one of which is a specialty skater known as a pivot, who is wearing a stripe down the center of their helmet. Pivot on that last jam for the Ultra Violets was Smash Anthem, for example. And now pivoting for the Smack Pack, number 2NA, Ellen DeGenerate. I'm trying to see who my other pivot is. It looks like that's Ripper in half. Those skaters, at any point in time that the jammer wishes to relinquish her status as a jammer during a jam, they can do it with a star pass and hand them off. The jammer now for the Smack Pack is...
Break number 227.
lead. That is now another grand slam pass. And there is yet another. We don't have a and another 5-point grand slam for Wimbley. Nice move by Breezy Days there to recycle quickly to back to slow. Extending that lead from 57 to 6. In a battle of the Gargantuan Titans from the developmental program here at the Dungeons of Destruction, Gooder Green, number 45, is jamming against Megan Shrine. Though they be ladies are about to say something that you don't get to see very often in sport and roller derby. On skates, I guarantee you, we're only about 3.5 foot tall, so enjoy this one, everybody. And we've got Abbott calling for an official timeout. I'd always like to thank our good friend Bernie for stepping in at the last minute and coming in and taking some photos for us. Bernie, la joie, thank you very much for showing up today for us. Those in the Bernie community are familiar with Bernie. He's been around the circuit for a long time. Great guy. Had a legal procedure and a legal star pass occurred on that last jam, and they were just squaring that away. The pivot is sort of a penalty. Therefore, it was not an actual jammer penalty for taking the star. Once again, if you are involved for liberty, you know one thing, you can't just grab somebody's helmet. Do that now. And do the two. the news track coming.
Thank you.
Yeah, so it's going to be a lot of problems. You can't be seen under the same shoes. Very efficient shooter. As you can see, how quickly she picked up the 5 points right there. And the first pass. She's got to stop blocking with a quick and clean up, putting driving.
There, and she is off to the sink.
Bertolini there, aka Rainer, with a nice job recycling Mango back to the pack yet again. And it looks like Mango should pick up one more point at the tail end of that third attempt to pass. Waiting for a squirrel game before we get to that last jam. It was 91-11 in favor of the snack pack. And it is now 110-11. Snack pack in the lead. The Epsilon is jamming against Ripper and Ham. Showing Pansy Footwork that's made her a stable rotation for the Garland Supernovas. Skirts around the outside, he's up a quick 4 points. And we've now got a classic matchup here. Gabby St. Andre going against Dominique Bertolini. Two of the best buddies on our Supernovas team get an opportunity to jam against one another here today. Oh, and it looks like Gabby wants to play a little cat and mouse ringer out there. Couldn't get the jammer take on that one, but I know she's happy that she lifts a little ringer down to prevent her from scoring. Darlings, we'd like to thank the Great Meet, our wonderful host here today, for allowing us the opportunity to use this as our venue for our practices and our home games. We'd also like to thank one of our other sponsors, Leslie Tire, out in Mount Clemens. Wonderful people at Leslie Tire said, thank you to my family's company on our part for many years. That was a nice jam to take out there. Bertolini's got the jammer run back going on Slander D, and Slander got caught in the trap and is now going to sink in a certain time for that well fought out run back by Dominic Bertolini forcing the trap. Trying to unload that star, giving it off to one of her teammates. She forced into the track cut, and she too is now set as a jammer into the penalty box. Thank you. the things I love about working with these kids coaching is they are very good sports. We've got 3 TDs jamming their hands. Vanessa Bondit, once again. 3 T is a recent transfer here from the local league. And the Dartmouth are thrilled to have her as part of the program here. Yes, quick gets the jammer. Now let's get some kind of penalty there. Here's Mitch Lake Strong. And Breeze is out to not be jammer. Yes, picked up a couple points there, and don't like the looks of it anymore. As she got forced to track set and called it off after picking up 2 more. That brings our score to 119-11. Just under 3 minutes to go in the half.
Even further.
Casey Ford, and keeping to the middle of the track there again, working hard for Gabby. She pulls off another 5-point grand slam. Gabby, is it time for more cardio? And we are halftime, everybody. Before we get too far away, once again, we've got some big sale stuff going on and some Barons of Destruction merchandise for all of our fans out there. And I'd like to thank all of our friends from the Detroit Derby Girls, and I see members of Jet Life here who played last night. Skid Row, talking about you, playing hard against the Cincinnati Banner Rams last night down the Dearborn. The Running took a loss, but they showed a lot of spirit out there in that game. Everybody have an opportunity to get the success stamps. Feel free to do so. And we'll be back in 15 minutes. is now as your lead jammer. Cubilo has worked her way through, and she's going to transform Point of Romance. It takes a little bit of a heavy bump from one of the Little Ireland teammates on the American Megatron. And Mangle has got another grand slam pass of her own.
Yeah, all out quick.
we're going to get a redo with the same jammer as the Angel P. That was a real quick jam on you guys throwing out.
Getting to be about that time where we're getting ready to draw our 50-50 raffle.
So if you haven't fought them, you're going to be left out on the pole on this one. Hey, little hits. Little hits. I would like you to assist us with the raffle draw. So if we can get the tickets on for the 50-50 raffle up here, and little kids with it, we're going to go ahead and pull those numbers. So if you got in on the Red Wings raffle right before this next game begins, little hits, hopefully it's your buddy and it's your number. And she reaches in, she stirs it up. And our winner, based on the name written on the back of this ticket, is Michelle Martin. I like how Vigilante's like, oh, come on. So guess what? We have a winner, and it is Michelle Martin. I think that's mine. And the official review was trying to overturn the Jammer Trekka against the Smack Pack. The officials have conferred, and the call stands. So the Smack Pack is going to be starting short of Jammer at the beginning of this one. And yes, paint drop. I believe you just need to talk to them over there, probably. They'll take care of it. We also have a score correction. The score is 39 for the Ultra Violence and 235. Pardon me, 36 to 235. Score to 235, Smack Pack, and 40. 2 for the Ultra Pirates. And we're going to see Breezy Days jamming for the Ultra Pirates versus Gabby St. Andre. Quite a nice hitball by the River Dancer. Gabby was able to maintain her balance position on the track, and she is through quickly with the lead jammer. Nice little spin through to the inside. And that's a grand slam for Gabby St. Andre. Gabby's getting a little bit of help there from her teammates, Ellen and Nessa, who are creating havoc amongst the ultra-violence defensive line out there. You know, I just saw Biscuits and Crazy last night at the men's tower, and even though she was Minnesotan, I'm still certain I know she's capable of cheering louder than she is right now. So if you got involved in the Cash Money 50-50 raffle for $7.2 million, actually $70, sounded better if I said $7.2 million. If you are in on the 50-50 raffle and your ticket is 007-4099, last four digits 4099, you are our grand prize winner. Oh, we got a winner. Going over to the concession area, grabbing their winnings, and then buying me a brownie. Recycling Gabby St. Andre. But at the same time, you've got Vanessa and Ellen doing their own bit on recycling. It's the Go Green theory of the barrels of destruction, where it's all about hanging on the leaves and holding on to those points. Once again, we're running low on time, and if you wanted to get some goodies from either our bake sale or from the concession bar, we've only got about 10 minutes left of the game. The bake sale has just gone on 50% off, so it's half off on the bake sale right now. So if you got a sweet tooth, this is your opportunity to get some goodies made by our home skaters and their families. Bird half honor with the sip in. And Wikipedia out with a 5-point pass right there. Here comes this. Wiki scooting through on the inside for another quick 4 points. Denying lifts any on the pass. Through for 4 points on her initial score attack. And Stepping on the jam line, we have 56 going against Nestie Crunchle. Casey's got Breezy working out for me with Ripper and S3 and Cooter Green, the triple angel. Dennis got out quickly, got the jammer Pixie, not very far behind. Bolt jammers got a couple points there, and Pixie hustled towards the end and picked up a few points for all those like three. That brings our score to 301-54 in favor of the segment. Play defense by the whole team. We've got Bruce Smith jamming for the ultraviolets. And Gabby Sanders is out as being jammer for the segment. Actually, we're getting down to about the last 5 to 6 minutes of the game here. Managed to keep that one skate in bounds, rolled it out on the rail, and came through with another 5-point grand slam, just like you did right there. We've got about 3.5 minutes remaining in the game. And I'll give you a score update here in a second. It's 309-57. And Fry Baby powers her way through the opposing pack and picks up lead jammer for the snack pack. There's something you don't see every day, about storing their pennies and coaches. Although it was the coach's hand in the first place, I think she was just trying to return the favor. Here we've got Brigger Jalen again. She's going up against Ellen DeGenerate. A couple of teammates from the Downs of Destruction Supernova squad going head to head. We've got Ness and Put, Gabby Sinatra, working really hard, Dummy Burley, trying to channel her inner body thunders to get her on that tremendous defensive role. Still struggling as the Smackbacks have been maintaining hard defense. And that hard defense resulted in a track cut against Dominic. Once again, if you're hungry and you want to grab a bite, before you head on out the menu, all concession food and bake sale goods are 50% off at this point in time. Once again, all concession food and bake sale goods, half off. There is no discount on Downs of Destruction merchandise because we have number one in the world and our stuff sells no matter where you go. The bake sale has sold out. Thank you everybody for that kind of support. The bake sale is actually sold out this evening. And Ellen DeGenerate also is hungry, hungry for more points. Despite a really nice defensive hip swipe by Gabby Sinatra, Tommy Perlini got through and picked up the points on that scoring pass. Looks like Perlini wants to go over and say hi to some of her favorite Detroit Derby girls while she's over there. I believe that's it. That looks like the official time on the game. And while awaiting the official score, everybody please feel free to step up to the track side so you can give a high five to all these hard skaters. Let's give these kids a big round of applause for coming out here and also hard today. Once again, we got a little insight into the talent that the Darlings of Destruction have been very blessed with as we have 50 plus skaters around the Metro Detroit area. Travel teams and our three home teams, something that's very unique in the world of junior roller derby, and we're real proud to have these kids representing us. Once again, things like the bake sale and pan sales that we've been here go towards our team pressing for a national championship, which they'll be competing in Lincoln, Nebraska, the second week of July. Thank you all for coming out. We appreciate your support. Representative from each coaching staff, which is both head coaches from the benches. If we can get the coaches up here to give us some MVP nominations, we greatly appreciate that. And we've got a couple of shout-outs here. Vanessa, you're amazing. Hello, Mom. And we also have a shout out for the Michigan Abolitionist Project, advocating for the survivors of human trafficking and the ending of modern day slavery. Thank you everybody for being out here today, supporting us and all of these wonderful skaters. I need skaters from both teams to please assemble in front of the penalty box for a team photo. Once again, all skaters, please. Get ready for a quick team photo in front of the penalty box. Thank you. Faster. And your coaching staff votes are in. Today's MVPs for the Ultraviolets, Breezy Days. And for the Snapback, Megatron. And those two skaters are not directly engaged in track pickup. Please come up and get your awards.